From the secret palaces of the Orient, from the modern masters of Hollywood, comes the most charismatic, most exciting, most reality-altering talk show in town. It's Marcus the Interviewer. Marcus the Interviewer, it's not just a talk show, it's psychological entrapment. They'll never see it coming, and they'll never know what hit them. One show, and the audience is yours forever. Join the masses and applaud, laugh, cheer, and yell his name. Marcus gets you in the mood. He brings out the person inside of you. He brings out your energy. He charms. He gestures. He enchants. He acts. He's a charisma. And around him, you feel like one too. Remember, if you don't use him, then someone else will. Act now while there's still time. Come in and tell your story. Come in and promote your brand. Come in and set the world on fire if that's what you desire. For Marcus is the guy who's got you covered. Legends are born, not made. Stars, celebrities, and legends are made here at Marcus the Interviewer. You come in a civilian and leave a superstar, because that's just what Marcus does. Watch Marcus on weeknights with the hottest commodities and superstars in town, and join in on the fun after work. Sit back, relax, and let Marcus do his thing. Come be a guest on the hottest, most talked about, culture-driven show, Marcus the Interviewer, where stars are made and legends and icons are celebrated, every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 p.m. Central Standard Time to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. Allow your favorite brother and friend to take your brand to the masses. Marcus the Interviewer is ready to tell your story.
Shout out my lock of my leg. Oh, see, I didn't even know that y'all was there. Listen, welcome to a brand new episode of Marcus the Interviewer Show. You already know how we do, people, every Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. You already know how we do. Listen, I hope you had a good Tuesday. Mine was like real busy, like a little crazy busy. It was hot, you know what I'm saying? And you know I'm big and stuff like that. So you know I like to sweat. You know what I'm saying? But it was good. I really did have a good day. So on today's show, let me ask you a question, family. Let me ask you a question. When do you see two women that's part of the same team that's killing not only TV, not only film, not only business, not only marketing, not only teaching, not only consulting? Listen, I can go on and on and on. I promise. It's like a never-ending story. You know what I'm saying? But these women are killing it. They're killing it separately, and they're killing it together. So at the end of the day, I'm honored, you know, because I come from women. Like, I got a mom, grandma, 9 sisters. Like, I come from women. So I am honored to have these legends grace this show tonight. But family, you already know what I'm about to say. I can't do nothing without my theme music.
Hey, yo.
What's up, babe?
Yo, this is the one, bro.
Oh, yeah? What's good?
I am telling you, man, that cat Marcus Boyd, yeah. You know, the interviewer.
Yeah, I know that cat. This is the one, bro.
That's me. That's the guy.
Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. You want the Scooby, gonna give it to you. No matter the conversation, he's already prepared to go and get into it with you. If you want somebody that's willing to listen with positive information for the vision, then all you gotta do is give him a call or catch him on his Instagram. That's all, and he gonna get with you like ASAP. They gonna tell you where the place at, and he gonna give you every single thing you need in order for him to, like, make that dream happen for you. You believe in it, do what you do. Competition is sacred to flu, so if I was you, I would just jump on the plane, cause he
yo.
Coming through.
Yo, it's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. Some people call him a connoisseur.
That's this guy.
You ain't never had it, you about to get it, cause Marcus is about to give it to ya. Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. The conversation king, Penny's the ruler. You'll never find an interviewer that's cooler than leave you feeling like he already knew ya. It's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. Call him a connoisseur. You ain't never had it, you about to get it, cause Marcus is about to give it to ya. It's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. Conversation king, Penny's the ruler.
Woo! Mr. Marcus Boyd be bucking and bucking and bucking on him like a bronco. Catch you with them conversation combos. He ain't with the he said and the she said. That ain't the way that it's done, yo. That real deal. Holy feel. It's so for real and you can feel that. He escaped from all of them imitators, so you know that he know where the real at. Like A1 on your plate, son, but it's all good. We don't knock that, but his ball flogged with his hot sauce. And he paid the cost, so we rock that. Get your now, ladies, and your lemon heads with your popcorn and your soda pop. Now go ahead and buckle up for the ride, cause in a second, yo, the show drop. Yo, it's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer.
This show about to start, there we go.
If you ain't never had it, you about to
give it to Marcus, the interviewer. Every Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, now we do.
King Penny's the ruler, you'll never find an interviewer that's cooler than leave you feeling like he already knew. It's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer.
Call him a connoisseur. You ain't never had it, you about to get it, cause Marcus is about to give it to you. It's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. Conversation king, penis, your ruler. You'll never find an interviewer that's cooler like, aye, 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 aye.
See that? See, listen, let me tell you something, people. Shout out to the minister in Atlanta for doing that jingle for me. Marcus, the interviewer show. Shout out to the man, the legend himself, the minister. The amazing gospel rapper. Listen, I need my theme music like fat people need cake. I need my theme music like people who exercise need a treadmill. So listen, I'm about to bring on one half of this dynamic duo. I want to make sure I'm pronouncing her name right, because, you know, hooked on phonics didn't kind of work for me. So I want to make sure that I'm pronouncing her name right. So because I'm having a little bit of trouble with her name, I'm going to let her come in. I'm going to let the legend come in, because, you know, she's a legend. So you don't want to mess that up, because you know what I mean. But I'm going to let the legend come in and introduce her famous self. And we're gonna talk. So, how are you doing today on the Marcus the Interviewer Show?
Hey, thank you for having me. This is Omegia Keeys.
See, that's why Hooked on Phonics didn't work for me, because I promise I can't spell. I didn't even know it say Omegia. Nice to meet you, Miss Omegia.
Nice to meet you.
And we are filling in for your other half.
Yes, my business partner and my bestie, Kathy Taylor.
Ah, that's the bestie. Okay, now. So tell me and my family. It's a two-part question. Tell me and my family about you. Then tell me and my family about how did you and Miss Kathy connect?
Ooh, okay. Omegia Keeys. I'm a writer, director, producer, camera op, / a whole bunch of things in between. My journey started in the military, and then I segue into filmmaking. And I met Kathy very early on in my personal filmmaking journey. After I filmed my web series, I ended up meeting Kathy through another mutual friend back in... Well, I think I met Kathy like in 2014, but we didn't work together on my stuff until 2016. Yeah.
Okay. So was you in any wars, like any wars when you was in the military? Did you experience that?
I served in the military from 1997 up until 2014.
Yeah, you was in a war. Yeah, using a couple of them. So how was that experience for you, being a woman and in the military? And how did...
Oh, being a woman in the military, I mean, I dealt with a lot of sexism. I went in the military because I joined in the 90s. There was a big transition before 9/11. 9/11 changed a lot of things for women in the military, but prior to that, I mean, you're going to deal with sexism. I dealt with sexism. I dealt with racism. I dealt with all type of stuff. So, you know, being a woman in the military is no different than being a woman in everyday life. That's just point blank, except that we just have guns.
Okay, talk to her.
Yeah.
Talk to her.
Yeah, it's a more... Wow. Smaller population, more condensed, but, you know, so it's more in your face and blatant that, you know, I still get it today. I could say recently for Veterans Day, and not Veterans Day so much as Labor Day, and for, you know, Memorial Day, all of the holidays for veterans, you know, when I go places that are supposed to get discounts or things like that, I could, you know, when I used to be in my uniform, or am I wearing a shirt that clearly says I served, I still get questioned. And it's because I am a Black woman.
Listen, I'm making a protest and a stand and a statement right now. Golden Corral, you question her one more time. When she had the buffet line, you better not question her when she sit up here wearing an I serve shirt. Like, she ain't talking about she served in the cafeteria. She not served in the cafeteria. She ain't serving the sports event. You better put some respect on her name. She ain't Birdman.
I'm laughing because you said Golden Corral. The Army loved feeding us Golden Corral. So that's the fact that you said Golden Corral out of all places. Like, you know, sometimes when we go to lunch, they'd be like, oh, let's go to Golden Corral. And I'm like,
I'm about to join the Army. It's official. I'm about to try to take my little ass bath. I'm about to try to join. So what made you want to get in film out of all the careers you could have got into? What started your journey?
What made me want to get into film is because I've always, when I was younger, we had an old film reel. I was always a writer. I always wrote stories. Like when I played with dolls or action figures or anything like that, I wrote scripts back then. And I always wrote short stories. I always did that type of stuff. But we used to have this old film reel, like a projector and stuff, and it was broken. And I used to try my best to put it back together. I never could get it put back together. But in the process of that, I used to make up stories so I can tell my family and just like, I'm like, skip it. Y'all don't have to look at that, but y'all gonna look at me tell these stories. But
Whoa. Did you hear Miss Keys? She sold her family. Y'all don't gotta look at that, but you gonna look at me tell these stories. You know what? We about to drop a bomb on it. She got bomb.
Yeah. Hey.
So are you originally from Atlanta? Tell my family. Are you, Miss Keys, originally from Atlanta? And if you are, I have to ask you the question that everybody that's from Atlanta get asked. I'm sorry.
No, I am not from Atlanta. I also come from a military family. My father was in the military, retired from the military, didn't work for the DOD. So I was born in Indiana, but I have been all over. So
she's a Midwest baby. Yay.
Yeah, kind of.
Okay.
I mean, I was born there, so, but like I said, I have been all over. Yeah.
Listen, I wish I could travel like she has. So let me ask you a question. So was it hard for you to navigate through the waters of filmmaking? Was there support there? Was there no support there? Like, how did you really get your foot in the doors that you have your feet in now?
Oh, no, I got it in the mud. I started when I got into filmmaking, I started out on a show called The Originals. I started on the very bottom, started out as an extra, then moved on to being a stand-in. But as a stand-in, I was able to learn the whole business because I could see everything. And I worked on that show for 3 seasons. I worked on a lot of other shows in between when that wasn't, when we weren't filming, but I worked on that one consistently for 3 seasons. And that like was my start because like I said, I can see everything. And I knew like from the first day I stepped foot on set, I knew that's where I wanted to be and where I needed to be. Now, was this easy? Heck no, because once again, Black woman, people don't expect to see you there. They expect to see you acting and everybody automatically, oh, you want to be an actress? No, I don't like acting at all. I've done it just to get my foot in the door some places, but I do not like acting. I love creating and I love putting it together. And I love, you know, if you can give me the camera and just let me go, I love doing that. That's me. So, you know,
wow.
I had a lot of
true filmmaker. Family, yeah. Listen, I want to be like her when I grow up. You know what I mean? Because I try to take my flip phone and I tried to film my documentary with my flip phone. I forgot it was a track phone. So it only gave me 500 minutes. So like I really couldn't get far with a track phone. But what made you choose Atlanta out of all places, LA, New York, like Virginia? What made you choose Atlanta?
Why go be a small fish in a big pond? When I first came to Atlanta, Atlanta was just starting to boom. They had already filmed some movies here, but Atlanta was just starting that real boom. They hadn't become as oversaturated as, you know, LA. you know, because everybody wants to move to LA. Everybody wants to do that. And, you know, when you watch movies, you see other movies that are filmed in New York or on the East Coast a lot. I didn't want to go there because the East Coast may as well have been, you know, back in Indiana with the cold. So, no, I wanted to be warm and I wanted to be at a place where I can build a network. And it just wasn't a bunch of people that were had been in the industry for so long that you couldn't build connections with them.
So would you say as a film director that networking, building those connections, building those type of professional friendships is very important and a key ingredient in the success in the film company?
Yes. And let me clarify, when I'm talking about networking and collabing and stuff, I'm talking about giving both ways. It's not out there. You're not just out there seeing what you can get. You have to bring something too. You have to bring a need to someone else in order to get your want. You can't just go out there like, I want, and you're not giving anybody anything. Because I have a lot of people that come to me now. They say they want to collab. They want to do this. Okay, but what can you offer me? Because I don't need anybody to collab, but because I got a partner and we got this. So anybody else coming in, what are you bringing?
She sounds just like her business partner. Let me tell you something. When I first met Kathy, it was years ago. Okay. Like I begged. Okay. I mean, Keith Sweat begged. I mean, Kiki Wyatt begging with Avon. I mean, like I begged just for a piece of her time. Because anybody who know the legendary Kathy Taylor, she is humongously busy. Busy. You understand what I'm saying? When she says she busy. You understand what I'm saying? So at the time, before I became an autism activist, before she became my PR, I mean, that took work. You understand what I'm saying? Before all this, you know, I wanted my music heard. So she was just doing Woman on the Rise and all that good stuff. So I was just like, listen, if we can just put one beat in there, I don't care if it's in the beginning, end, middle. I don't care. So she was just like, listen, if you show up to the auditions and if I see that you really want this, then I talk to my team that day and we'll make sure we try to put one of your beats in the thing. Say no more. I stayed all 2 days. Now it was 3 days, but I stayed for 2 days. Say no more. I will start bringing women off the street. Listen, you look like you want to be on the rise. Come on upstairs. I'm like, I didn't care because I wanted to show her that I was serious and I can bring something to the table. Years later, we're still here. Still bringing music to the table. So if you really want it, you'll do whatever you got to do to go get it. Absolutely. So with that being said, can you name some of the movies and stuff that you and your partner has done together or TV shows or anything like that?
Yeah, we have 7 films that we've done together. The one that just released is called Faded Reunion. It just released on Saturday. It's streaming on Tubi. The one before that is called Shattered. Surviving America. It's also streaming on Tubi.
America. That's people. That's good. I seen Surviving America. I kind of got misty. Yeah. I did. I kind of got upset too. But
it's going to make you upset. It's going to do that. We have Shattered. We have From Jim to James Crow. We have Women on the Rise. And we just finished filming. Like, I'm editing right now, so I had to take a break to do your interview. I was in the middle of editing Keeping Secrets, which is our next project, which is a thriller. But like I said, go watch Faded Reunion on Tubi right now.
Well, before this interview ends, I'm going to drop a secret to my family, to Ms. Keys and Ms. Taylor, that nobody knows. So I'm going to drop a secret too, since we all just dropping little secrets. I'm going to drop a secret too on this interview. They got to deal with Ms. Keys and Ms. Taylor. Okay? We're not done yet. Okay. But so as an African-American woman in the film industry, when you got to Atlanta, everything was starting to boom, new stuff like that. Freaknik was still going on.
It did not exist when I got here. Freaknik was already long gone.
I think it did stop at 94. I think it stopped at 94, 95. I think it did.
Yeah, I didn't get down here until 2013. So
it was gone. Yeah, it was gone. It was in Florida somewhere. It was in Florida. But as a when you got down here, did you find it like difficult for people to embrace you and your thoughts and your ideas, or did it? Did you find everybody was loving, you know, hugging on you and wanted to help push your thoughts forward?
Let me clarify this. When I came, I was coming straight out the military. So my mindset was a complete different thing at that time. If you were trying to hug on me and stuff like that, we were going to have a problem. So no, I did not like that. But I came with the mindset that, you know, I just wanted to be in the filmmaking business. So it didn't matter what people said to me. It didn't matter if people embraced me. I was there to learn and then do it my way. So I didn't give a dang. I was there to be a fly on the wall, and I was there to work hard on other people's stuff until I was able to do my own. So it didn't matter if people embraced me or this and this. But, you know, but through my work ethic, people did embrace me.
So would you say your work ethic... So would you say your work ethic made a way and a door for you?
Yes. Yes. Putting in the work for other people showed them that, you know, that I belong here.
So let me ask you a question. What is something that we don't know about Miss Keys? What does Miss Keys like to do when she's not working? Where you like to go? What do you like to do when you're not in front of a camera, behind the camera, on the computer editing? Like,
is there anything else? I mean, what? No. No, I have a husband, I have kids, and I even have a grandbaby. So, you know, I spend time with them.
You got grandbabies?
Yeah.
You got the little one?
Yeah.
Oh, no. You don't even look like you're 21. Then no. What?
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Mommy, grandmommy, breaking down walls and barriers, historian. I mean, like, is there anything that you don't do? So
I don't.
When you write, when you write your movies, and do you write TV shows as well, or you just write movies?
I write whatever pops into this brain, and I have so much that from years and years, you know, that I've worked on, that I've redone, that I've done everything. No, I do TV series, you know, as well. So it's not just one thing.
Have you done something that we can see?
Yeah, Shattered is a TV series. It's on Amazon.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm definitely going to check that out. And excuse me, Ms. Kathy, I know we talked about this a while ago. Listen, don't beat my butt. Listen. I am. Really, I'm going to check it out. But so word around town is that you are working on some new projects. Are we able to talk about the new stuff that y'all are working on? And by the way, y'all showed a tour of the studio that you're working in. Let me go ahead and tell you something. I think I fired my cameraman out of my other bedroom because he didn't have the studio capacity that y'all had. So,
whatever.
So I was like, you fired. I had a Donald Trump him.
Oh, gosh. No. You got to get it where you can.
That studio was so beautiful and remarkable. Like, can people just film their films there? How can people work in your studio?
Oh, it's not our studio. We work in conjunction with, Live Canvas. Yes. So, you know, they can rent, the studio anytime. Just go to, you know, the Live Canvas website and they can find it that way. But it's really beautiful. You can, they have an area where you can build whole sound stages, or you can use the private rooms that they have, plus the site. Well, I mean, we turn it into whatever we want it to be. So, you know, if we can do it, you can too. But yeah, you can go online to their website and you can like rent spaces from there. But I would advise you to actually go through my business partner, Kathy, before you do that, because if you don't, you know, you get what you get.
you better go through Kathy. You better go to Tell All In. They better tell it all.
Yeah.
So do you, in the future, will you be interested in doing music videos or, you know, anything?
I have done music videos already. It's okay, but it's not my thing because I like big, you know, full pictures. Like I've never been a short story person. I've always been big world building. Like you asked about some of our projects for the future. In 2023 in the fall, we are trying to film our vampire series, which is like Blade meets the Purge. And that's a TV show, and that's major world building right there. So that's where our lives live. So yeah.
I don't know if I'm gonna be comfortable like watching like somebody like sucking blood like from another person in reality life and stuff of that nature. Kind of not there yet. I'm not a Walking Dead fan yet, but
hey, I mean, it's a lot going on. It's not just the vampires. There's a lot of other stuff going on too. So fast forward through the vampire parts.
So if a young woman wants to become the next Miss Keys or Miss Taylor, if they want to become the next female writers or whatever, what type of pearls of wisdom can you give these young women?
Get out there and get in those areas that you want it to happen. If you want to be a filmmaker and you don't know where to start, go be an extra on the film set. There are so many positions. There are so many jobs out there in the film industry that you would never even know exist unless you stepped on a film set. There's no excuse for you to, if you want to be a filmmaker in this world, because there's so many films filming. If you're in Atlanta area, there's so many films filming. Like Marvel films like 3 different shows at a time here, and there are so many other productions besides Marvel here in LA. If you want to be an extra, they're always looking for extras, so there's like no excuse when it comes to that. And if you want to be a writer, how you start being a writer is freaking write. Start writing. That's how you start being a writer. And if you want to know structure and all that other stuff, let me tell you, I learned everything that I need to know about writing from Google. There are so many resources out there. And, you know, I published my first book back in, in 2006. I had to think about that. So there's way more resources now. You published
your first book. So how many books do you have published?
47.
You know what? You know what? Family, I gotta stop what I'm doing. I don't care. She about to get this. She about to catch it. She about to catch it. Listen. That's so incredible because some people can't publish one. And she's writing movies and TV shows, and she still managed to write 47 books. Listen, let me go ahead and tell you something, okay? I'm going to need you to be my ghostwriter, okay? I'm not even trying to play with you.
That, I can tell you right now, people ask me that all the time about ghostwriting and things like that. That is honestly not my lane, because I have so many things in my head, and I have so many years worth of work that's backlogged in my brain that I don't even have the capacity for someone else's stuff. Now, I can edit someone else's stuff. I can publish someone else's stuff, but I cannot write someone else's stuff. But I can gladly send you to some people that I know that can do it, but that's just not me. And that's just the honest truth.
You see people, I had to bring her in. Some people call her Batwoman. Some people call her Marvel 2014. I had to go ahead and bring her in because, again, like I told you people, she's busy, okay? That's why she's moving around right now. You probably see the camera start moving. You know what I'm saying? Because she's busy. Don't know where she is, but she busy. So, you know, welcome the legend. I call her legendary PR. That's what I call her. I call her legendary PR because she's my PR. You know what I'm saying? So welcome Kathy Taylor, Tell All Inc. Future, right here. Like right there. You see them. You see the double twins.
Hey, bestie.
Hey, y'all. Sorry.
Hi, Bestie. Hi, Bestie. Hi. So I would be remiss if I don't ask you, Miss Taylor, how did you get started? And are you from Atlanta? Or did you, like, you move to Atlanta?
I was born in Chicago, and I moved to Atlanta at a very young age.
Yes, and some people don't know. No, don't type that in. No, she's not from Grady. No, she was not born in Grady, Crawford Long, stuff like that. No, no side. She's from Chicago. Okay.
And how I got started with Tell All Inc., that really started from I was coming out of real estate background, general manager for a mortgage company, and the industry was starting to tank at that time. And I needed something else to sustain, you know, what I was doing. So I created Tell All Inc., you know, on the side. And I actually even had it, and I just sat on it even probably a year and a half, 2 years before I even started the business, actually getting things going. It literally, when the industry tanked, I was out there like, oh my gosh, I have to do something else. And then birth Tell All Inc. And then everything else is history. Meeting Mimi, she put her hands around my neck and said, you're going to do this?
Who's Mimi? I'm sorry. I'm not good with names. Who's Mimi?
That's me. Omega. My name is Omega.
You Mimi.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yes, Omega. But I know her. This, because we're friends. I call that. But you can't.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. Sorry. Excuse me. Yes, ma'am. It's Keys.
Yeah, that is a family name. So, yeah, that's not for the streets.
You heard it, family. They in our home. And they said we can't. Right. Family. Don't get upset. Don't. Right. That's her prayer friends. So how? Which one of y'all said to each other, look, girl, we about to do this. Did Kathy tell Miss Keys that we...
Me.
Oh, you told her first.
Yeah, she told you. I put my hands around her neck. No, I didn't do her like that, but... I
so you Ricky Lake her? You Ricky Lake her? You Jenny Jones her? Oh.
Okay. Yes.
She basically tells me, reminds me all the time that, yeah, I stalked you and I wanted to work with you. And which is actually an important thing just in life and in business, because when you're doing work, make sure your work is great. So people do want to work with you. They want to work with other people who's about their business, getting things done. And I had no clue that Omega was watching me, or, you know, for the most part, when people, you know, say that to me all the time, you never know who's watching. So. That's a good lesson.
Right. In Atlanta, everybody's watching. You understand me? In Atlanta, everybody's watching. You understand what I'm saying? You can't go down the street. Yeah. Like, everybody watching. And I told my stalking Kathy story earlier. I did tell my stalking Kathy story earlier. I did. Because I
Why
did.
Do I stalk? I need to change. Everybody's stalking me.
I did.
But a lot of people don't laugh.
No,
that's great. I love it.
They don't. So, as I asked Miss Keys, Miss Taylor, why choose filming on television? What made you? Because, you know, people, family. I don't know if you ever been to one of them tell all events. Let me tell you something. I've been to it. Like, she's an incredible decorator. You understand what I'm saying? Listen, let me tell you something. If I ever find a wife, okay, wife number four, wife number four, whatever the number is, if I ever find her again, she's going to be decorating my stuff.
Oh,
she's going to be decorating.
So you said why TV, film?
Right.
Because number one, again, it is because, you know, I've done a few little things prior to being Omega, but once we got together, I mean, you know, going through her stuff, asked me to be part of the project, you know, I've always been interested and I've worked on those projects, doing their events and stuff. But it was from another perspective. She came to me and said, hey, I want you to produce all my projects with me. And I'm like, okay, because for me, producing is, even when I have to do an event, I'm producing the event. So for me, it was just another way to produce. So it wasn't taking me out of my comfort zone. When you're already a boss, when you're already a leader, and, you know, especially, and she gives me the freedom, just do whatever you do. And it just, she just let me on her projects just do, she trusts me enough to allow me just to do my thing. And that's big for me, you know, having a partner who sometimes I'm afraid and I'm like, okay, Mimi, what about this? She was like, girl, if you just do it. And I'm like, because, you know, my thing is because that, I respect
that's because
her
Ms.
so
Keys
much.
Didn't have training wheels when on her bike. When Miss Keys was a small girl, they ain't put training wheels on her bike. They just pushed her out and told her to keep pedaling. That's why.
Basically, just what they did for real in real life. That's what my brother did.
And it's not even that I'm not confident enough to do it. It's just I respect her so much that I want to do a great job to make sure, you know what. Her vision, because if you ever can get inside her brain, I mean, if you watch our films, you know that it's extensive and you're like, who thinks like this? Who does this? So I just want to always make sure I'm doing, you know, a great job for her, because not only I win by default, but, you know, it's important that she win and we win. That's it.
But by directly doing what she does, it allows me the freedom to do me and to do even more. Because once I know that she has things on one side, I can go crazy on the other side and be even more. So it just works because she's not stepping on my toes. I'm on her toes. We're just working in tandem. We're using our strengths and we're just together.
Okay. Okay, hold on, because I don't know what tandem means. Let me go ahead and get my little dictionary, and let me go ahead and swipe up so I get my little dictionary. But it sounds cute. It sounds cute. I like it. It do. Tandem.
Tandem. In tandem, working together. Yeah, like links. Links. Links on the bike. Yes. Tandem.
You know about connecting and links and you. Yes, Marcus.
So do y'all find it, because they say a lot of women can't work together, they say it'll be arguments, they say that, you know, jealousy, envy, stuff of that nature. How have y'all lasted this long and still besties, friends, working together, all that amazing things?
Because we don't subscribe to that. We allow each other to be who we are.
Hold on. Flag on the play. Did you just not say, Ms. Keys, you don't subscribe to that?
Exactly.
Okay. You about to get it. Yep.
Oh, boy. It's comical.
I had to do it. I had to. Sorry.
Well, and without that, that's incredible. You know, we
every female team needs that.
Yeah, but again, like Omega said, we stay in our perspective lanes. I'm not trying to be her, and she's not trying to be me. And it doesn't mean that we don't always agree on everything, but we understand we have enough love and respect for each other to, even if we don't agree, okay, I'm gonna give her minute, she gonna give me my minute, and then we have a job to do, so we can't sit in our feelings. And bigger than that for me, she always makes sure, it despises when people try to belittle or don't, you know, have me at a level where she feels I am. So when people try to disregard me or dismiss me, she's actually my biggest cheerleader on that. Like, no, hey, no, you're going to see my partner. You're going to give her her flowers.
I mean, I think because, that's why... I think that's why I stalked Miss Kathy for so long. Somebody told me that I was in the circle with that new Kathy that, you know, she was the deal. I saw her at the women's award show where Tina was giving out awards and stuff like that. It was like, look, if you trying to do something, you know, maybe you should let her hear your music. Say no more. Okay. So I saw her car pass at Chick-fil-A. Okay. I wrote down her place. And you ain't never know that. I ain't want to say nothing to right now. Kind of wrote down your place. You know what I'm saying? Really kind of stalked.
But look, when you're talking about that award show, I was right there clapping for my friend. I was right there.
Yes, she was. She showed up. And she always shows up somehow. If she can't be there, she's supporting in some other way. And you need that. So whatever she needs, I have it. You know, I have her back. And in friends and even in business, that's what you need. And you understand that we're here to love. We always have great days. We have bad days. We celebrate the wins. And we cry and keep it moving.
So I will ask you, Miss Kathy, the same way I asked Miss Keys, if a young lady or young ladies want to do the same thing you and Miss Keys are doing or differently, want to get in the film industry, what advice would you give them so they can help them along their journey?
Find you a mentor in the business, and it's okay if you've never done it, to start at the level so you can understand every position. I mean, recently we had a young lady that worked with us that has, you know, have never done it. And when I tell you, she showed up and showed out. And even myself, I had another young lady who wanted to learn design, Miss Barbara, and she came on and she took it on. So she listened to the advice. So you have to be coachable. If you're not coachable in this industry, you're not going to last. So it's not always about showing up and being at the top of the food chain all the time. I mean, we have put our time in, and we tell people, learn it. Starting a business sometimes at the lower levels, you understand all of the stuff because you see everything.
Yeah.
And you're able to navigate through it. So I would tell, find you a great mentor in the business and just, you know, CA or in anything you do. Even on my events, I have people all the time come to me and like, hey, Miss Kathy, I want to learn a business, or would you train me? And I tell them, you have 3 times to work me. And it's really, I don't even tell them no, because some of that is, let me see how far and what you'll do under those circumstances. And most people like, oh, because if this is about a check for you in any of the industry, this is probably not for you, because a lot of people in the film industry are not, especially on indie films, you're not being paid $1 million to work this stuff. We work long hours, so if you divide it out, really, it's a lot of work. You have to love what you do.
Yeah.
Let me tell my family something, because again, this marks the interview show, so I can be real transparent with my family, because my family. So there's been a lot of times where Kathy was like, yeah, I like this beat. I want to put it in a show or a film or something that I'm working on. Marcus didn't get $1, okay? Let me tell you something. At the end of the day, it's not about the money. Marcus was homeless sending her beats, okay? I mean, homeless, okay? You understand what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, it's not about the money. It's about the love and the passion that comes from it. It's about the legacy that's being built towards it. You understand what I'm saying? That's what it's about. So, Miss Keith and Miss Taylor, how can people get in contact with you? I mean, I need your, like, WhatsApp, your pen, like, your Facebook.
Well, everyone can follow me under Tell All Inc. That's on all of my social medias. And all you have to do, if you need to reach out, you can email tellallinc@gmail.com. That's it.
Hey, all right, you can follow me at AFM Media 1922, and you can follow our movie page at Faded Reunion Movie.
Yep.
Yeah, I like Ms. Keys. She sounds like a telemarketer. She worked as a telemarketer in her past. Like, I don't care what nobody say. She worked as a telemarketer. She was for the paternal order of the police. Like, listen. So I do got a secret. Got a big little secret for my family. So I'm going to bust it out before I end this interview. So I am working on a book, autobiography book, The Boy with No Voice. So we're working on that. That's my PRs. Yeah. We're working on that. So in the next year, I plan on going to Paramount Pictures with an all-female directing team, all-female executive producer team. So the two females that will be head directors are the females that's on this live. They will be directing The Boy with No Voice, the TV series. Okay. So,
okay.
They will be directing The Boy with No Voice, the TV series. Okay? So, not a game. It's coming. Okay? So, they didn't even know that. That's why their faces like that. They didn't even know. You know what I'm saying? But they are.
Well, I know you was on something because you kept asking me, do I direct TV series? 2 and 2 = 4.
It does.
And I know so that's your honored to have your heart.
As the film directors, because what I want to do is I want to tell a project story from a kid with no voice in the projects and how he had to really deal with his disability and his autism growing up the way he did with no voice. So,
but Marcus, you have a great story. You have a great story to be told. So,
on the small side. So, I want to thank you two legends for coming on the Marcus the Interviewer show. You will be back because I don't care. Every time you put something on Roku, every time you put something on Tubi, I'm going to want it.
Well, we appreciate so your support and love.
Yes, thank you.
I love y'all. You know what I'm saying? I support y'all, period. All the way from the Cal State in Little Rock because I'm in the Cal State because all I see is cows.
Tell them move for me.
All the way for the
count. Yeah, let me hear that move.
Hamburgers are free here, okay? Hamburgers are free here. Milk is free. Well, all the way from the Cal State, Little Rock, we are so proud of you. You're legendary. It's just an honor to even know y'all, to even grace your presence and things of that nature. And I look forward to what y'all have to do in the future. And family, you already know what it is. To the next buffet line, to the next Subway sandwich. Listen, this has been Marcus, the Interviewer show, and you already know what we do how to do. We're gonna begin like we about to begin. So let's go.
Hey, yo.
What?
What's up, big?
Yo, this thanks, is the Marcus.
One, man. Oh, yeah?
Thank
what's
you
good?
So much.
I am telling you, man, that cat Marcus Boyd, yeah. You know, the interviewer.
Yeah, I know that cat.
This is the one, bro.
Ooh. Okay.
Mr. Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. You want the Scooby, gonna give it to you. No matter the conversation, he's already prepared to go and get into it with you. If you want somebody that's willing to listen with positive information for the vision, then all you gotta do is give him a call or catch him on his Instagram. That's all, and he gonna get with you like ASAP. They gonna tell you where the place at, and he gonna give you every single thing you need in order for him to, like, make that dream happen for you. You believe in it, do what you do. Competition is sick with the flu, so if I was you, I would just jump on the plane, because he's coming through. Yo, it's Marcus Boyd, the interviewer. Some people call